it.
Hello again, welcome to part two. We're now about the lake.
Well,
morning swim. A big old plane above. Back on, thank you very much. Sorry about that. Thought YouTube had got rid of that problem, but clearly not. They need to update their servers to work with the latest equipment. It's not good, really. Hello again, Roger. We're nearly there. We're now about to pull into the farmyard. Welcome to the old stables, everyone. As far as we know, there's another three people booked on, so that'll be as many as you're allowed on the lake today. A lovely lake in their garden there, well, it's their pond, that one.
Mm-hmm.
I remember rightly, this gate opens towards me.
Did you say come into
Patty? I don't know, because she came out last time when we pulled in and she came out.
You did say it's going to come see us.
Plane's allowed. Yep, there's three cars there, exactly what they said. Bear with us, everyone. Obviously, we've got to get all the gear out. One from swims.
I think he's going to come and find us.
Oh.
Stephen just managed to touch the electric otter fence and got a shock.
Didn't get electric
shocks
there.
Don't wake you up.
Jumped on
yourself.
Coming or what? Before you go to the toilet.
Huh?
Going to the toilet or what?
No, I'm all right. No, I didn't know where it was. Right. Go check it first. And...
I felt that.
I really did. That's the one that comes every week.
Is he?
Yeah, I reckon. Has he got a dog with him?
No.
No, there's two. Oh, there's two brothers that normally come, and you normally come on Tuesdays. He said.
Oh, I thought Colleen got unbelievable. Nice long bit there. Lovely.
Carl's fault. He didn't get here early enough.
Huh?
Said Carl's fault. He didn't get here early enough.
Yeah. Well, he's
but I said. But then I did get back to sleep. So I kept waking up.
Look shop which is gone. Okay. Oh, I've got one. How many doors he got?
Yours is the back
under
yours.
Oh, I got it here. No, I've got mine. How many flippin' others you got? Yeah, I noticed that. Put them together, man. Oh, yeah, that's the rinse.
Toilet block. No. Right, so there's someone there. There's two people there. There's one, is it?
What?
Coming off.
No, what?
You have to just chop it down or something. Yeah.
Right then. Take a swim.
Let's kick out a ball.
right, everyone, we're pick swims. We can see carp all over the place. So we'll get our gear down there, I'll get you on the old stand. We'll find some fish, hopefully.
It's cold.
You're cold?
Yeah. I'll be right when the sun gets up a bit higher. It'll warm up a bit.
Maybe you got to dip your own one.
You
need to
pick them up in the rain or something,
I don't know.
Yeah, whatever. There ain't nothing down there, the toilets or not.
Green one.
Right, so we even need that then. I don't know if I just take my float one. I don't think I want a float. I think I just, I don't know. I might just leave it to them. Oh.
Right, yeah, just let's say just
yeah.
Right, nothing else now. Shut the door, gate.
Yeah. I'm gonna stop far soon, so you can always come back.
Yeah, it hurts your legs. You've got to get
this. Oh,
it's yours.
No, you
right, everyone, we're in our swims. Let's get you down with us, see if we can get set up and find a few fish. Don't know who that is.
Guess what, gather that ship from the place.
You can't get it.
Oh yeah, come to the place. Flipping big dog.
You know, I heard you anyway, come on. I would have heard you if you were at home.
I think I'll just bring it off.
This is your float rod.
This one just hit me. You've got a brand new float rod.
You still wrapped up, sir? Turn the light on. You've got one finger, Jimmy. Alright, everyone, let's get to the swim. What I'll do is I'll pass you around a bit. Stay with me for a little while, and then I'll give you to Joe for a little while. And Stephen, and you can get to see everything again. Lovely lake. Yeah, I see it, yeah.
Oh. I've got a problem, mate.
What?
One where you picked down there. I've got the hat on, you can see the tree above
me. What? Well, you can cast out of there. Call yourself a fisherman?
Well, I look really nice swim, and I see a tree sit there.
You meant to be a fisherman? hear me, everyone. I'm just getting set up here. So we got no worries, you can see that. Basically long grey rods. Big eyes, as you can see. Gonna put a Shimano 8010 reel with it. Bear with me, everyone. Huh? Hunting everywhere, everyone. They're in the car on me pods up, but I only want one here today. If you can still see what's going on, everyone, just bear with me. Hi, Angela, Peter.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick one on that tree and then one just out a little bit in front of you because there's a lot of bubbles coming through. I still need to find my ones, because them boat alarms don't work very well without them.
Huh?
They don't seem to pull through them well enough. Sometimes they don't work.
Thank you.
have a roll. Bear with me a second, everyone. All right, everyone. We'll move over a bit. All this rod is out. Sort the legs and stuff out because there's all uneven ground here. Put you here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to fish down the side here with a float rod. Well, we've got the boilie rod out here. But obviously, I've got to set that up as yet. So how you doing, Mick? Hi, Angela. Hi, Backlash. Major. Connor. So I'll leave on that rod for now. We'll be setting up a float rod in the background. Trying to work out which one I should use today. Should I go with a heavy line on the float, or should we just go 6 pound? Just take a bit of this line off the rail, it's a bit worn on the outside. I don't even know, it's only done about 6 trips. Right, for the float rod today we're going to use the Drennan 13 foot continental carp and the Drennan 7 series reel. I'm going to go 6 pound line. I don't know how well you can see, but there's a lot of the plan. I've got the rod, you can see in the picture, is down to the left with some boilies that me and Joe make. Don't seem to go anywhere without catching on them, so hopefully that'll be good. And then at the moment I'm setting up a float rod to fish a set of lilies to my right, which I'll let you see once we get a float in the water and get it all plumbed up and stuff like that. Got carp into high 20s in there, tench over 11 pound, some big bream, some big roach. So let's see what we can get feeding and go from there. Seem to be quite noisy here, we've got planes, tractors, all sorts happening. There's a fair few people on the lake today, as me, Joe, Stephen, and then there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 other people by the looks of things. The good thing is though, we've spoken to the owners and they know we're filming and stuff, and you know, sort of advertising their place, so they're going to give us permission to fish till dusk. When normally at shuts at 6, so that's nice of them, appreciate that. There's also a campsite here as well, so you can bring your caravan, there's toilet block, all that sort of stuff, electric hookups and all that sort of thing. See, we've got a few fish definitely moving around the margins and out in the middle on the surface. They're everywhere. So just bear with me while I set this other rod up. If anyone hooks up, I'll spin you across to them so you can see them playing the fishing. I've also got a particle mix with me, and I've got some chili hemp with me as well. Hopefully that will be a good attraction for what we've done. I've actually baited both the spots already I'm going to fish at the moment to start with. And I can see fish coming up and activity in the swim, so hopefully things will happen. You have to use their nets here, but you have to use your own pole. I've got no idea of the depth or anything yet, because I've never fished here before, so plumb all the depths and everything and work out what's what. There's a bit of a branch sticking out in my way where I want a fish. I'm going to pull that back in a sec as well. Now putting the weights around the float. That's a shame because there's a lot of fish down on the swim where I've baited already, but I'm going to have to lean over there and pull that branch out of my way so I don't get tangled if I hook a fish. I can see what most people are doing, they're sort of casting around the lilies, and I'm going to go for a different approach to that. I reckon that's what everyone do. Heard a beep on one of Joe's rods then, but I think she's just resetting one of them. Alright, let's get this float down in the water. Make sure it's floating properly. That's a bit too high still. Let's try again. Spot on. That'll do nicely. Right. Still got a plumber depth and stuff as well. Alright, so land the net's all set up. We need a plummet. They're a bit loud, then. Right, a couple more small jobs, move this pile out of the way. Put the car keys away somewhere so we don't lose them. And plumb a depth and then we'll get a bait. Oh, Joe's got a bite. Got it? Joe's in already. Good start. She's beating us. Bear with me because the ground's all different places, all uneven in different places around here. Joe's got first fish. I had to work out with the fish care here, everyone, because you have to use their nets, but I want to put them in the cradle, really, to handle them, which is the same, really, so it hasn't been rammed to let me know. I think fish care. This has all been steam cleaned since I last used it anyway, I always do. Nets, you need to supply mats as well, right? No. I'll see anything here. I have to keep resetting everything because the ground's all uneven. beating the boys already. Joe's beating the boys already, everyone. Okay, everyone. Mr. Carp. Lovely, nice one. Get it back in the water. A good start. Yeah. Joe's already had a fish before we even started, probably. So that's not bad. I'm sure there'll be some more today as well, and I'm sure they'll keep getting bigger. Yeah, the only pain is the uneven ground. I have to keep resetting the tripod every time. That's not a problem. We can deal with that. Right, where were we? We were putting a plummet on the float rod, weren't we? Lift method, yeah, that could be done, yeah. Trouble we've got at the moment is most of the carp are on the surface, they're all over the place. Didn't you have your one on the your clutch going? Yeah. That's the thing when you fish places. We got our, you know, homemade baits and stuff. They haven't been used before in these, you know, new lakes. Right, so I'm a bit over depth. So exactly how I want it to be. I want to pick it up and go off with it a little bit before they do anything. I don't know if you can see, but right in front of us, there's a double figure carp swimming through. About a rod length out. They're literally all over the surface. Okay, so what bait do we put down the side here? I think we're going to go for a bit of the old spam. Just going to cut a little piece out. I'll say a little piece, that'll probably be a big piece. Let me get this on the hook and I'll show you what I'm going to do. I'm to go too big on the side of the hook to start with. And I'll go bigger when I need to, if I need to. Let's see what we start to get bites off first. See if we're going to get carp, tench, bream, etc, etc. So this is what I'm going to put out there this time. How you doing, everyone? Machine NZ, how you doing? What I'm going to do is I'm going to creep around the side of the bush here. I'm going to plonk this down. Tap on the boilie rod then. That wasn't me. I can sit here, I can see the float from here. What I'm doing, the float's down and the lily's down there like that. And we'll see what it does. So if you want me to put you in a different position, just say. I can show you the float, I can show you what's happening with this rod. We can keep switching it up. We've got a few taps on the float. What's down there? When I first got here, while I was setting up, I fed it with this. So I've got a load of particle just sitting down there. Hopefully that's moved in some bigger fish. Hopefully some tench from carp will be feeding down there. And we should be able to get a bite. A bit of luck. Well, not luck. It should be planned. Yeah. How we want it to be. Well, so I can set you up however you want me to, I can keep you where you are. I'm literally now having the first cast. Oh, nice to meet you, Kevin. Yeah, I'm literally now putting the rods out for the first cast. We'll see what happens. And go from there, really. Mm-hmm. A bit of drag on the surface of the water. Yeah, Steve's up the other end, and Joe's in the middle. We've got a bite. Where are we going to hook up? Oh, there's good fish in the lilies. I can see them moving about. Someone is definitely chomping around our meat. Wanted to take it properly and then swim off of it, really, before we strike. Something running around my arm biting me then. That was nice. Not. There's definitely something got hold of the bait. It's moving about with it, but it's not swimming off with it. It's carrying on feeding by the looks of things. I Oh, that was a bit me, but that sting now. See the lilies and stuff knocking around, so I know there's carp down there. But there could also be smaller fish down there as well. Put the camera on a float if you like. Hang on. Can you see it like that, or do you need me to move some of these branches and stuff? You should be able to see it, I've got a bite. You can see I'm getting knocks, but they're not taking that away. Could be smaller fish having a go at it. Could be just tails off tension carp moving around. Oh, nearly went that time. Oh, I nearly struck it, nearly. That's the trouble, I've got the camera right there and... No, you're not allowed to. That's the trouble. There's loads of fish on the surface, they're all over the surface, but you're not allowed to surface fish. Did think about going like a foot under the surface, something like that, maybe. I need to move that branch out of the way that's in front of me, really. So I can strike upwards when I need to. So if I can reach it to pull it around. into a branch. There's obviously branches down there. Shouldn't put that back in there, not the branch. Right. Let's attempt to move that out of the way, shall we? Don't think that'll be that easy to do, though. Stick, move. You can probably see we're back down there, a bit further out this time. All bites straight away. Oh, do you have one, do you? Huh? Do you just add another fish on? Gonna bite again. Got to be smaller fish down there, haven't they? Oh, we missed that one straight under and gone. That was a shame. Put a smaller bait on this time and just see what happens. I'm going to go for a double sweet corn this time. Literally got a fish coming up and down in front of me. Bite again straight away. There's definitely fish down there. feed up the quarterly rod. Leave it in the sun to dry out. Leave it in the sun for a little while to dry out. Recast that one. They're not really going off of the corn on this side, but they were the other stuff. Had a bite then, didn't we? Strange, they pick it up and then put it down again. gonna get a bigger one though, like 10 plus, gonna be able to boil over the 4. Right, everyone, I'm gonna take this week one off because that's not doing anything. I definitely don't want that. Well, not right now, anyway. I have got some maggots with me, so we're gonna try them and see if that produces anything. Hello. Are you not fishing?
Just going around.
Yeah.
I've done my figure
with it. Nice.
I've got to do something, you know what I mean?
You getting bites?
I've had a couple last week for them, but I ain't really. It's hard work under that tree, it's done my head in.
Down the sizes where I'm getting the bite.
Yeah. I just keep thinking about under there, over there, it's all tempting, but. I've had bites on sweet corn and they just go. I'll chuck a bit of bread out and. That went straight after it.
Yeah, what they would.
It's all annoying. Bread on hook, you haven't touched it.
Could try like a foot deep or something like that.
Yeah, I've done 20 minutes so far.
What?
I figure, bud, you need to
see
that I'm doing something. He's
going to
say we're doing a video.
Machine NZ is saying hello to you.
Hello.
Oop. Oop. That was a good time to come. Oh, I dropped it.
You won't believe it. I can't. I've left the hay rig behind.
Don't. You want one?
You sure?
Yeah, I'll find you
one. Sort of
saying that. I slipped up in my pot. Someone had to go out for you. Look, 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 look. And the board had taken everyone. It went round and stopped. That's a pain.
So I'm not in the live, but I'm doing a video at the minute. I'm doing a video, so there'll be a video come out. I don't even think about going. It's still upside there. I went and said, I said, that's right.
Oh, that is there.
I get sad. I said, is that peg over there? I can't see you. That so called Mr. Wilson.
Yeah. Go over there if you want. I'll better wave to you. There's a carp right there. Look. Mm. Crazy.
I said something.
It's big one as well.
I said the willow trees.
In the way, is it?
Like, yeah, move around. Strike. I saw.
Move wherever you want to go. I can wave to you.
I don't see me on that head corner anyway.
No, I can't. Not really.
I see you. Well, that I shake a hand about something. What's all that about?
Two right there. Look.
Yeah. What's all about the hand for? What's happened?
She's had a carp and she lost a carp.
Oh, has she?
Yeah.
I haven't talked to her then. Didn't know that one.
Well, you didn't see a fish?
No.
What?
No, I didn't see nothing.
She had a common little straight away, literally straight away.
You got in the lake when I caught.
And she lost one out in the middle a little while ago.
I'll go chuck you in a minute. Nasty.
Look at them, they're really annoying.
Yeah, it's right side so mine as well. It's like right across just in a bit front of bread went. Pew. I went straight after it. Anyway, stop talking to me, Brad. Yeah, it's really fine.
I'll dig one out, so I've got to go.
No, I'll go right. Rush.
There's carp all over us in front of us at the moment, everyone. It might have been what happened on this road a minute ago. It might have been a line bite because they're all swimming through.
Hold on, you said, oh, we'll use one rod and one on the float. And if you use the two rods, hold on, if you use the two rods, you use the four. There you go. Oh, hold on.
You'd think I'd take a bunch of maggots under there on the float, wouldn't you? Or something, wouldn't you? Even a roach or a tench or something like that. So on that we've got a bait. We had a nibble. Strange because normally a tench or a carp or something like that would just grab all the bait and swim off all of it. They seem to be just nibbling it and playing about with it at the moment. Hiya Pam, how you doing? There might have been a smaller fish trying to take it. So we've got a few fish knocking around in the margin to our left then. And there's plenty of fish all over on the surface. But that's not really helping us on the bottom, is it? I'm sure we'll better feed them and, you know, get them to move down as the day goes on, but I'll try other tactics if I have to, if I don't start getting a few fish soon. That's a lovely place, Pam, yeah. Really nice place. I'm here with Stephen and Joe. Joe's in the lead, she's already had a common carp. And she already lost one as well. Me and Stephen are not off the mark yet. I am getting a few bites. I've had a couple of aborted takes on me boilie rod to the left here. Surprise, maggot's not doing anything either. But then it is down there on a better particle, so. You shouldn't have said that, you should have told him that was 22 pounds.
What?
Should have told him that was 22 pounds. Oh. Come a helicopter. So it looks like the only thing that's giving me bites down the side there is going to be me, so yeah, so we're going back onto that. We'll just, we'll land and weed, I think it'll help us. Just gonna have a quick cast out into the middle and just see if we get a point. Like so, probably nowhere near enough depth. Just to see if we get a rod or something to take it. I've never tried before. Straight on. Oh, missed it there. go back out in the middle again for our first cast. Should be able to see where that landed. Yep, it's gone again. There's definitely fish out there. But obviously they're going to be smaller fish, I would have thought. Let's see if we can get one just to see what they are. They were sort of bites on the drop, really. Now it's gone down. It's stopped again. I think I probably changed my shot pattern so that fluttered down. Could probably get a bite. There was actually meant to be some big rod and big roach in here. You'd say the big rod would be on the surface. Going to sit there too long because I haven't fed the area enough and I'm going to need to start feeding it with a catapult and trying to get a few fish, you know, coming up for it and stuff. We'll have a couple of casts around just to see if we can get a quick take and hook up. Oh, my boiler rod just had a tap in without my alarm going off. It's strange I actually saw that. Here we go. Float went flying under there. That was a shame. Yeah, I don't know what happened on the boiler rod then. I had a good tap on that then. But I didn't scream off of it or anything. I didn't even register, which is a bit strange. They're definitely out there. Oh, carp on the surface out there. Fish on. I need the net. I need the net, please.
Something's tugging away. I don't want it to be flying off.
I'm going to have to go down to Joe, everyone. She's got one.
Nice,
that definitely worked, everyone. Just grab a disgorger and take you up to the mat. This is what I'm on about, trying all different things, different tactics. Sometimes the one you don't think is going to work does. Bear with me a second because the fish has took the bait in and got to get out with the disgorger. Crazy, but it's a pretty fish. Lovely, pretty fish. All right, let's get it back. That's a good thing, the water's right here. On straight down. Your turn, Stephen.
You sent them on 10 minutes,
that's
not there, so
slowed your weight up away from your trace. Oh, fishy everyone, fishy. Good start, yeah, good start, definitely. I'd say Joe's had one. I've now had one. Stephen needs to get one now. Bear with me, that's one of them places where it's got very uneven ground, so I have to keep readjusting everything every time I move you. Right, that paid off, so what we're going to do is try that again. Float slid down, we don't want that, do we? And if I lost a weight, oh, that slid down, I think I lost a weight. The one that opened over there then, the chap fell off his box. Somehow. Right. Let's have another go out there, shall we? There are some much bigger fish in here, in like high 20s, so hopefully the boiler will pick them up. Yep, I'm on the board. Kevin. Pam's team Joe, are you? Pam's on your team, man. Pam's team Joe. Me moving the rod, I want it more of an angle downwards. I'm going to give this a bit more of a. What have we got on the bottom of that? Oh, they're a bit chewed up for something to take them, aren't they, really? Right, I'm going to throw a bit of meat out in the middle there for a second to give it a couple of casts. Martin W, how you doing, mate? I've had a mirror, Joe's had a common, and Steve's not off the mark yet. Can't say I've seen any ducks, seen a pigeon. Yeah, there definitely are some birds about, because I can hear them behind me, but... Cool. They're fighting in the trees, but they're pigeons, they're not ducks. What I might do in a minute is move the boilie rod around to them lilies and then start baiting a swim out on the float in front of me, because it's not doing too much to the left of us.
baits down.
Let's put a bit of meat back down
in the lilies. See what we can do there with a piece of meat on, see if we can get a carp to feed there. Got a little lift bite. Someone picked that up. There's a pigeon. Talking about the pigeons. I think there's like cruising carp and stuff like that in there as well, so they'd play with the fluke. Oh, we missed that one, didn't we? Or even hit the camera. Damn. Trouble of having to strike upwards over that bush. Let's try again then, they're clearly down there. Going with. Piece of meat. Let's put the rod on top of it this time, shall we? Try that way around. Is that messing your view up? Yeah, it is really. Trouble I'm having to strike around that bush. It's making me strike to a funny angle. Which is what I don't really want to strike at. Mad in the trees. feed then, actually. Strange bites down there. So I reckon they're cruising carp or tench or something like that. They're not like a big carp, but just grab it and go sailing away with it. Hopefully we'll hook one in a minute and find out what they are. Two pigeons are in a tree above now. Don't know what they're fighting about. Yeah, they keep picking it up and they're moving around with it and stuff. But they're not really taking it away like they would normally. Yeah, the bigger fish. Yeah. Branch where I've got the rod there, I really want that branch bent back into the bushes a bit, really. I might grab that with the net in a minute and just bend it back and wrap it around one of the other branches. And then that'd be a lot easier to strike and not get caught up in the tree and stuff. Oh, that took it and let go of that done, didn't it? Definitely playing around with it. Strange, it's just picked up and moving around with it. Right under them, but that's the pain with this bush here. Gotta be smaller fish in there because it's not getting taken properly. Come on, take it properly. It's giving me a headache holding the rod out, I guess, above this branch. Crazy, just sitting there messing about with it. The carp on the surface just in front of us. Don't know how well you better see it, but yeah, you should better see it in the picture just there, right in the middle of the picture now. Not scared at all, they're literally just swimming around like that all over the lake. It's just sitting there right in front of us. And the way it moves. Yeah, I'm thinking about it. That's a long way in the water though, look. I don't want to fall in moving it. Look, it's this whole thing here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put the end of the landing net around it in a second. Get out of the way. I'm just going to wait till the end of that bite, but I don't know what's happening there. Bait's gone off it, so. Alright, let's get the net and get that moved, shall we? Right, that's that out of the way. Now we might be able to fish a bit better. I'm going to go a bit shallower so I'm not right on the bottom. A lot of fish coming up there in front of me. Might just have a quick go for a couple of them. I think there's a mate over there on the. Yeah. And the pole has got one. we can get one off. Just see if we can get a tag out there. You never know. Oh, we can see a few fish around it. Maybe they're going to go down and take the meat, it's a different thing, but they're in the area. Oh, fish come up right next to my float there, look. Oh, she's swimming into my line, look. Crazy. The chap on the pole has got a bit nicer fish. I think if I'm going to fish like that out there, I'm going to have to go like a foot deep, half a foot deep, something like that. Right near the surface. I saw there's got one over there, sort of 3 or 4 pound. I hope I got a bite. Let's see what comes of this one. Definitely surprised the old boiler rod isn't doing nothing. If I stay quiet like it is, then we'll cast it out in the middle. Put a PVA bag on, so it's got some bait around it. We'll have a go out there. Oh, we've got a load of ripples coming up from where I've got the baited spot, is there? So we could actually get a bite any second. Rodels them out there taking this. Don't know how deep it is out there, that's the thing. Plenty of smaller fish moving about. Oh, and the big fish just moved on the end of the tree there. Which ones are going and ones are inwards? I think I need to be putting the spoilie wood down in there, I think, unless. Just did a tap on the spoilie rod again, tip the tip's tapping, but nothing's picking up and going off, you know, away with it. Getting the same sort of bites out here as I was down there near the lilies. Let's get it back down there near them, where them lilies are. In the lilies now. Right, now we've moved everything out of the way, let's get a better view. Let's hopefully get a fish. It's moving around straight away again. This time I should be able to stroke probably. Or lift bites, so they're picking it up. Oh, I weren't looking then, it came back up, didn't it? I was looking around at the boilie rod because the tip of the rod's getting pulled round. I would say that probably just took my bait because that was under and gone. Man. Just wait a sec, I'll reckon that's off. No, we've still got a bite. What's that all about? Oh yeah, it'd be a good fight, but that's all part of the fun. I'm normally quite good at getting them out of the reeds and stuff. Strange that this boilie rod ain't gone off, as I can see carp, you know, making waves in the water down where the bait is, where I'm sitting. Here we go, carp on. And guess what, Pam? Straight in there. Still got it, still got it. Oh, it's going well. It worked though, didn't it? It's come out, that's out. There it is.
Mr. Wilson's here. Told him Mr. Wilson to be here. Oh, what a pretty fish. Scourger. We left the scourger there. Good colours. Stay with me, everyone. Decided to swallow it. We got it. Jumped at me hand. Didn't want to do that, did we? Alright. Let me try and steady it because it's going crazy. And there we go. Mr. Fully Scaled Mirror. Lovely jubbly.
I can't say much. I had three roach.
You had some roach, have you?
The bays they turned up.
It's going crazy on me.
Everyone, it ain't as big as that look.
But let's drop it, get it back. And it's back in the water.
Do you find it, Scorcher?
No. I think I left it down with Joe.
No, we look. What colour is it?
Yellow.
Quite yellow, well, I would have seen that.
Bright yellow.
No, nothing down there. It's really beautiful, look.
Thanks, Pam. Not allowed to use it, Martin.
What's that?
He said dry floating bread.
Ah, Martin.
We can catch hundreds like that.
I'm waiting for him to turn up.
They're all around me.
Kelsey. Oh, Joe said, don't leave the stuff. Don't say, I said, you can't that stupid, I bought them in.
Yeah.
Beats over around the minute. I thought I'll come out and won't run up. Plopper. He's letting him talk to him. 21 in. I've done half old figures, so.
Yeah.
So far. I'm going to see what's been said and all that now. Back on. I'll do it a little while later. No break now. Oh, you can stand there after I talk to him. Your yellow, is it a scorcher?
Yeah, it's bright yellow.
Bright yellow,
float rod, yep, that's on the float rod. Exactly what I'm doing. I've got a boilie rod out as well. Down the side here. I keep getting pulled, but I'm not hooking up. I'm going to guess that it's going to go a bit quieter down here now after that fish, but you never know. They're down on the feed, they're near the feed. Back on the spot, we'll see what happens. I lost a couple of weights, so the float's going to be a bit higher. Until I sort it out in the next car.
Just check your pocket.
It's in your hand.
What?
It's in your hand.
No. Oh, you say it's in my hand.
I won't put it in my pocket.
Oh, That's what Drew told me to do. No, I won't record it. I got my hands like that. Wait for that. Look. What are you talking about then?
That won't be far away.
That's just weird. He's still talking to him. Oh my god.
Yeah, he'll probably do it everywhere.
No, he started doing it anyway. Don't do it.
They're still down
there. You got your flute out there. What'd you catch it on then?
A little bit of meat.
On the flute?
Yeah.
How are you caught on the flute?
We had them both on the flute.
How was you caught off? Oh my god. Good jammy sword.
Okay. Jammy about that.
I can't get a bite on it in a minute.
I'll get a bite of cast.
One lunch.
I had that mirror right out in the middle out there.
Oh, so you haven't caught one on the ledger yet then?
Going shallow. No, keep going round and then a boat.
Oh.
It must be small fish.
I've got to do that thing for you. Don't forget, we've got to do that sometime for Megan.
What's that?
She wanted food for us too. Buffer glass on, the hats on. She's solid. I think Megan's sort of like, rather like doing some matches, she said. But you're fishing. I thought, yeah, but I don't put the other mention and say, well, I can pick up tomorrow. Can't believe I'm not though, literally short.
Yeah.
Oh, Peter, are you in there?
Oh, was it you?
Don't. Peter, anyone who knows about my bug being stolen? I'm getting it back tomorrow. The police gave me a text earlier and said, I'm having it back. I can pick it up today, but it's obvious I can't. So I'm picking it up tomorrow. Come on. They might be little roach as well, you know.
Yeah, they probably are.
Ain't all carp, I know I'm getting some bites, but all of a sudden I keep being roots. I think what to do next, that's so annoying. I know, I have to use lunch and meat, I've just chopped it all up.
Just go bigger baits.
Oh. I've tried sweet corn, but every time I go on sweet corn, I'm getting roots.
I can't really get nothing on sweet corn, it didn't do a lot.
I might start again for a bit and then come back and wait for you to go over there. I'll be all,
you might even go that way.
Did you get the bike back? Yeah, I'm picked up tomorrow. The police has informed me. Heard you before. Oh, sorry, Peter.
See how loud he is, everyone? I've been sitting here whispering away, nice and quiet. Trying not to disturb anyone, because they're right next to me.
God.
Later on, when I think they'll all be around the edges. Mm. I would have thought. There's loads on the top in there. Mm. It might not even come this way, it might go that way.
No, it's definitely come this way, won't it? At least I'll catch it, isn't it? You see, now it's us with the videos. He fell in, didn't he?
No, he fell backwards, didn't he?
He did.
Yeah, I don't know what he was doing.
Donkey.
I don't know if he lost the carp or something, or...
Yeah. So I was like, you alright?
Yeah.
I'm getting it back tomorrow. Due to the rescue. I'll fish for a bit longer.
Yeah. It's your turn to get a carp. Yeah, I think I can catch the carp on there. Ooh, it's taking me right in the lilies this time. Are you ready for this? Go on, take it. Oh, how? how? Right under, even though the float's sticking up really high. They're still getting away with it. Let's go a bit further out this time. Just try down there a bit further. Okay, yep, cheers for coming in. Appreciate that. It's 12:15 here. Dinner time. Lunch time. Oh, here we go. Oh! We should add that one. Oh. Another aborted take on that. What's going on with that? They're definitely in the area. It's just not getting picked up properly and taken. On a lily. No. What? Oh. Nobody didn't lose anything. No, didn't lose anything. There's definitely stuff messing around with the bait on the boilie rod, but it's not going. Another branch here I need to get off. Not a branch or reed. Bite straight away. Take me as the lilies. What are they? Right off in the lilies. I'm gonna strike it any sec anyway. you still got bait on that one, look. Let's have a go right on the edge here, shall we? See a good few, there's a few nice sized fish out in the middle there by the looks of things. Literally just under the surface. See the lilies being knocked around, which means there's a bigger fish down there. Can we get it? Oh, that's annoying. I felt it. Damn. That was under them, wasn't it? The meat. Oh, why are we making noise? Again, I think. Get up. Want to read? Which made it. Lose the meat. Here we go, here we go. Oh! That was a carp. As you can tell by the bite. Lots of wildlife here, everyone, as you can hear. Move the boiler rod again. caught up with a lily or something, wasn't it? Yeah. Gonna say. That normally go quite quickly down there, so. Good for sitting on a lily, is it? They're in there. See them knocking around on the lily stems, shaking the leaves at the back here. Few fish rolling. Chap next door's bringing one in. Got a nice bite, but a sharp bite. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, I didn't even settle it, straight onto a bite. Must be a lot of fish sitting down there on the bottom, but maybe they're not carp. Keep putting feed down there and trying to feed off the smaller fish, but it's still there by the looks of things.
Yeah, I think I'll send two talk with them. Oh, he's got one over there. Just jump over there.
Just bring one in.
I've had six free on lunch meat, I can't believe it.
Yeah. What roach? Mm. Any big ones?
Huh?
Any big ones?
I thought that was, last one was a bit better. I got to show on video when we've done. Just one down. That's the flu. Same one. We're 40 minutes already. See, I don't do these little sort of 15 minute ones, I'll make sure this one's a longer one. You know what I mean? Over there, ducks are up, they do. Over there, too, I'm being lazy.
Yeah, just sitting there, aren't they? They're on an area or something.
I'm sure I talked to the screen, not you. Ooh! Got you. Yeah, I just sit about, I think. Oh, must be warm over that side. He's got his hat off and his coat.
Yeah, oh yeah, something's out over there. It's roasting.
There's someone inside the fish in his trade, the chat trade.
You can move any swim you want.
No, I'm talking about you two. I'm like, look.
I'm fine.
Carl's keep that
jewel. I'd rather be in the chair, they'll get burnt.
Yeah?
Or I'll get sunstroke.
That's true, yeah. That's a good point. Yeah, the jewel stage is getting cold. Now I'm bogging where I am. That's why I was hitched about over there, but I'm getting these bites over there. And one I think was a bigger fish. I mean, I'm struggling, that's what come off.
Yeah.
So I'll get them on lunch meat, that's just annoying. Also, if I'll go on lunch meat, I'll get carp and I'll say I'm getting roach.
I'm
And we're back, everyone. I was just talking to the owner of the lake. You're not old enough.
Huh?
You're not old enough. Do you want a rig?
Huh?
Do you want a rig?
I talked to you.
I said, do you want a rig?
I think it's a bit creepy that, you know. It's creepy now. It's been nice to me now. I don't quite know, you know. It's been nasty. I don't know where mine's gone. Yeah, but it's handy that. It's a little hard to see if I can find the information.
Oh, is that black, still black screen? I'm going to have to start part three. Anybody? Can anyone hear me? Can anyone see me? Is it still black screen, Pam, or is it back? Sound, no picture. Okay, I'm going to have to shut this one down and start up a part three.